In the first part of this video today, we will be learning how to derive the formula of the sum of arithmetic progression. Now, the first thing that we've got to do is identify the first term that is labeled as A and the common difference that is represented by the letter D. Knowing that, we can deduce that in a sequence, the first term is A, followed by A plus T and A plus 2D and so on. Since A represents our first term, we will use letter L to represent our last term so that the last three sequences are L minus 2D, L minus D and finally L. So now that we've figured that out, the sum is the total of the whole sequence where we add everything up and we're going to label that as the first equation. Then to get the second equation, we rewrite the same thing but in reverse order and label that as our second equation. And now that we have two equations, all that's left to do is substitute one into the other where we add both of them up, which will lead us to 2Sn equals to A plus L plus A plus L and so forth. So because we have an infinite amount of A plus L's, what's going to happen is we will have to simplify it, which will lead us to 2Sn equals to n A plus L. And finally, n over 2 A plus L. And then there we have it, our first formula. Last but not least, since we know that L equals to dn, which uses the formula A plus n minus 1d, we substitute that into the previous formula that we just discovered, which will lead us to Sn equals to n over 2 bracket 2 A plus n minus 1d. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for watching. Moving on to the next segment.
Hello, in this segment, we will learn how to apply the formula Aisha just explained about when answering a question. Here I have an easy example.
You're a wizard, Harry.
First thing first, we have to list all the values that is given in the question. Given the first term, A, is 45, and the common difference is negative 6. Now let's recall the formula that we have to use.
Wingardium Leviosa.
Next, what we have to do is find the sum for the first 21 terms simply by inserting all the values given into the formula and make sure to solve those in brackets first. And after your calculation has been done, you will get negative 315. Now, since the question asks us to find sum from the third term to the 21st term, we have to find the sum for the first two terms simply by adding the first two terms together, which are 45 and 39, and you will get 84. The final step is to find the sum from the third term to the 21st term. To do that, we have to subtract the sum of the first 21 terms with the sum of the first two terms, which leads us to negative 315 minus 84. And the final answer should be negative 399.
You've made a mistake. I mean, I can't be a wizard.
Now let's move on to the question. The arithmetic question, number 6, from 8 to 15, find the sum from the 9th term to the 20th term. The initial term, which is negative 6, and the common difference, which is 7. From both of the information given, we can use the formula A plus N minus 1D to find the 8th term and the 20th term, which is 50 and 1 to 7. And use the formula to find the nth term by the difference, the relation between 50 and 1 to 7, which we will find 12 terms between it. And from that, we can use this formula, which is the specific number of consecutive terms, which we will find 1062, which is sum of the numbers. Okay, that's all from me.
Ladies and gentlemen, it was lovely to have you this year. See you next year, or not.